Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, She sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless. And so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive. I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him, only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die.
back. Don't touch it.
You're curious.
It's fixed. What happened? The bridge is fixed. Let's cross it.
You can feel
me.
You need the runes to fight
Dillian.
You need Dillian. He's waiting for you.
He always said he
would. He's close.
He cares about you.
He is close. He loves you.
I'm calling you.
Dillian. Dillian, we're here.
Dillian.
We're nearly here. We can.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur, It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind the gate?
Where will it take you?
It's not safe.
Dillian.
There he is.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through
Dillian. Before he disappears.
Dillian, don't lose him.
Slip away too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillian, there he is.
Quick.
Where is he?
There's a soul.
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark.
Thank you.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
She really was.
He saw the warrior within. Dillian's in the tower. He's there.
We spend our lives searching for the meaning in life, and we ask the gods for guidance. But the truth to life is revealed when we can face death without fear. How can the gods understand us if they refuse to die themselves?
remember him whispering in your ear.
It's broken. There's no way you can fix it.
What do you do now, sir? You can't go up
you
there.
You can't go up there.
Not in this world. He was the only one that really loved her.
He did love her.
Was it worth it? It was Kyle's Kyle.
cannot be undone. He believed in you. You astray. You should have listened to your father when you had the chance. Why didn't you listen to him? His love has tortured you, and it tortures Dillian. stroked your hair. Do you remember the way he felt? Dillian doesn't know who killed him, but we do. She thought she had light within her when she has only dark. She is pure darkness. Do you remember him whispering in your ear? The way he touched you. He cared in a way that nobody else did.
Dillian's in the tower.
He's there.
She really was.
He saw the warrior within. Look what happens to the things you love. Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
There he is. Where are you taking them?
He's up there. How do you get them? There's a way. There is a way up there.
Find the way.
She can do it. You're nearly there. Just find the way.
She thought she had light within her when she has only.
She is pure darkness.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Balder. The blind god, Hoth, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hoth says, "I cannot see where Balder stands. And even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Balder. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Balder is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Things that are most precious to you. Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Balder. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
Your curse has claimed Dillion. Poor Dillion. He didn't know he was kind. You have blood on your hands. You are guilty. Was it worth it?
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dillion. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past, and Dillion, her future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
You killed him with your love because he believed in you. Do you remember how he made you feel? What does it feel like to be in love? What if they're all about wasting your time just delaying minute by minute by minute? What does she think she's doing? You're special. He's the reason she keeps fighting.
He saw that she was strong.
He didn't believe that she was cursed. He saved you when everyone else turned their backs. was kind to her.
Do you remember meeting him beneath the tree? She's alive at all. Do you remember the way he stroked your hair? Do you remember the way he felt?
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Thank you.
didn't mind the curse. He loved her so much. Dillian saved her.
You owe your life to Dillian.
You owe everything to him. He led you astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
I didn't listen to him.
His love has tortured you,
and it tortures him. You broke him. You killed him.
He couldn't see the darkness within you.
What if these trials mean nothing? Again, you can. Dillian saved you. Dillian cared for her like no one else has.
Dillian's the only reason she's still alive.
The Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down and turned these bonds to iron and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes. A reminder, perhaps, that if even gods must accept death, then so must we.
He was the only one that really loved her. He did love her. What if this is pointless?
What are you doing? Why did you think you could make this work?
You keep seeing runes. You see runes everywhere. We're lying. If you think it makes sense, but really the gods
are playing us.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense in the world.
The gods are playing, but it doesn't mean anything.
You can't read this language, you don't understand.
Sindel was right.
You're wasting time.
You're cursed. Will you succeed?
Too slow.
Quicker.
You've killed him with your love because he believed in you. Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld.
You're going to fall.
And looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Sindel.
You can do it.
I guess he took after his father, the chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see. And he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, learned to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I know.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we?
I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong. This has to be wrong. I can't breathe.
Can you smell the death?
It's too much.
Turn back.
Towards it.
He's in the house.
Find
He's
him.
Going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone? Keep going.
How do you find it?
It's just a trial. It's just another test.
You just have to solve it, and then you will find him.
Then you will succeed.
He's so close.
Just one little test to do.
You can almost reach him.
You can almost see him.
Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. The water. She could taste the rot. No one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing, and they knew that she was not like them.
It's broken. Fix it.
You have to fix it. How are you going to fix it?
You can't get to the house until the bridge is fixed.
You must. You have to get to the house. You have to find Dillian.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
That's it.
You did it.
She did too. It's not done yet. Just a small piece of the puzzle.
Come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there? Come out if you are.
Where is he? Find him.
You have to find him.
The runes.
Focus.
Focus on the runes.
Focus the runes.
Delia! They're coming for me!
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are.
They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
Killing you would be too easy.
They're taking your memories to torture you.
They're taking you from the inside.
You're disappearing one memory at a time. Every time you remember, it disappears.
They're going to take everything.
They're not yours anymore.
They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
They belong to the gods, not to you.
They're eating you from the inside. They want to kill your soul.
They want to crush it.
Body. They want your soul.
They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore.
Dillian's disappearing with your memories.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see. Who's there?
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I think I'm somewhere else now. That debris has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
Reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Shenhua. My father. He taught me the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. You're no coward. You proved that to me in the warrior trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your bet. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior today. We need people like you.
I'll do my best. is in order. I can't go on this way.
Then look for another way and tell me what you'll find.
There is a house. I don't know what's inside.
Don't be afraid.
It's not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards. I think I'm in a house. It stinks of death. The darkness is testing you, but you are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And a sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Dillion gave her the Warrior Trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back. The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Talia?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
See it clearly now, Senua. The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
Waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
She's lost.
She's lost. She doesn't know where she's trying to get to.
We're all lost.
Is there any escape?
We're all lost.
Is there any escape for any of us?
Thank you.
hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinmel, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy? voice of your mother, Galina. She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Darkness took her life, and it will take yours. It's taking you further and further into it. Surrender to the darkness. Darkness is here.
But she didn't run. She escaped the operation. Now she gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead?
Be close.
just look around you. What hope is there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he would thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
not fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Simba was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help, a little hope.